Hello guys, welcome to Gusto's New Music Friday. Like, I have two guests. Sheyi as usual.
Then the one after become two.
I have done it here, but before we begin, I would like to say thank you for all your likes, your comments, and your subscriptions. We appreciate it. That's why we're here, to always give you guys the very best in terms of music and entertainment in Nigeria. Before we begin Gusto Music Friday, we have Damipe here, who's going to spotlight his new song coming up soon.
Okay, so I've got. You've done yours. Yeah. I want to. Hello, guys. Welcome and introducing King Damipe.
Yes. The latest. The incoming superstar.
The incoming superstar. Yeah. Very, very soon. Nago here. Nago tire. Nago request for more.
So, Damipe, you have the floor.
Yeah, thank you guys. Thank you, Big Respect Chiefs. So yeah, Oyeki is dropping on the 18th of this month. That's some days from now. And I promise it's good music, sweet music. It's going to be on all platforms. So please, immediately it drops, just go grab your copy.
So guys, we're going to leave a snippet of what you're going to expect from Damipe's new single. Trust me, it's banging. It's very nice.
Thank you.
You enjoy it. Just take a listen. We'll be right back to present the Gusto New Music Friday, the songs we have for the week. There's quite a lot, so we'll get into it. I'll be right back.
Cause these days I wake up for night and I really, really, really want you for you. The kind of vibe that you give to me, I'ma get it so bad. Oh yeah, that girl, I'ma get my pummy.
Welcome back, guys. I hope you enjoyed that bit. I'm gonna tell you my favorite.
Oh, okay.
Is that your favorite? If I open my heart for you, baby, you go show say no there you go.
Stay.
my jam. We're gonna move on to Gusto's New Music Friday.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. There's quite a lot.
Ready?
We'll try to roll. We'll try and do it as quickly as possible.
No long time.
We'll start off with Reminisce, OG Reminisce, featuring Adekunle Gold. They have a new song out titled Toxic.
Okay, so the OG before IG,
yeah.
Reminisce. This guy has been consistent for years right now.
Mm-hmm.
And you know, yes, he dropped an EP, Fireboy DML, it was on that one.
Mm-hmm.
That's the name of the song.
Fireboy,
yeah. After the EP, he's dropped a new single, Toxic, featuring Adekunle Gold.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
Would I say I expected better from, you know, the both of them? Yes. So I hope this goes on me, but at first listen, it was giving
me vibes of the song they had with this producer, original gangster or something like that.
Yeah,
you should check that out. Next on our list, I have The Cavemen, who have a new song out.
Heat.
You never make me, I even announce them. Who no go, what do you call them?
Who no go, no.
WNKGK.
Yeah, WNKGK.
Wing kick.
Anyway, Uno No Go No by the Cavemen is for me is a really good song.
Yeah.
They've stuck to their style. They have perfected that style actually.
They've carved a niche.
I believe that for those who love the Cavemen,
If you love High Life too.
If you love High Life and if you love the Cavemen, you would love this particular one. Uno No Go No. Shout out to the Cavemen, guys. Your album is still one of the best projects out in 2020.
Dope. We're gonna move on to Joe Boy, who has a new single out titled Celebration.
Okay, so for Joe Boy Celebration, I think for 2020, apart from that song
Nobody.
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
Joe Boy hasn't really been informed this year.
Okay.
Yeah.
But he's still one of the most streamed artists on Apple Music,
well,
and Spotify.
With according to if you look at the Joe Boy standards,
yeah. What is the Joe Boy standard?
Joe Boy standard is that one, baby.
That's
a well, and a couple of singles that I released after then. But I think in 2020 he hasn't really, really been Lonely, for example, that I released before the Celebration song. Unfortunately for him, was dropped on the day the SARS thing, you know, started. You know, that all dampened the whole mood of the song. Celebration is a good song, but not a Joe Boy standard.
Really, I kind of like the song because I love these how will I put it, praiseful kind of songs, like prayerful, like you're telling your
you're from the church, so it's fine, it's understandable.
Who's not from the church? I'm from the streets. We're gonna move on to, finally we have an album by Tekno. What I want you to do is tell me your thoughts on the first listen of Old Romance and tell me the track or tracks that you're feeling.
So my very first question, you know, to Tekno would be, why don't you have a feature on this particular one? It might be trying to make a statement by saying, you know what, after waiting all these years, I want you guys to know that I can do this by my own. Now, it's not like Tekno doesn't have like people that he has collaborated with, but maybe it's going to be on the second album. But on this one, about 12 to 14 songs on the album.
It's meant for you.
Yeah, well, Tekno did his beat, but I think I could only pick about 2-3 songs of that album that I would still listen to, you know, over and over again. Enjoy, yes. There's also Designer, just maybe one other song of that album. For me, it's not an impressive project on first listen.
Okay.
Maybe it will grow, but I expected that Tekno would have a couple of collaborations on this album to make it quite diverse, you know, in nature. But for the for this one, nah, doesn't cut it.
My input is not needed, so I'm going to pass on that. Next, we have Bad Boy Teams. There's a new single, but under his label name,
Anonymous Music.
Anonymous Music, and it's titled Oge.
Oge. Okay, Bad Boy Teams has impressed this year. I mean, 2020 has been a year where we've seen a lot of, you know, blown up artists, Bad Boy Teams of Malay, Bella Shmoda, and of course, he's done well. That song MJ with Mayor Kun remix also is doing well right now. Loading is one of the biggest
blowing
songs at the moment, you know, been everywhere. And of course, that one due to Bad Boy Teams and Olamide as well. Oge is a decent song. He did one, Have Fun. I know, Have Fun. Before, you know, that's, like that's his own single. You know, not a bad song as well. This one,
seeing this, I don't even think perhaps they didn't know that they released this song, because the song doesn't sound all
recent.
It doesn't sound all good to me. I don't understand it.
For me, this song, I would say, wasn't needed, but I think that Anonymous Music as a label is quite, they're quite anonymous. You know, they're not,
so they're
known,
trying to make themselves,
so they're trying to make themselves, you know, known. And I feel that for this one, the strategy wasn't good enough.
Right, we're going to move on. There's Chinko Ekun, who also has a new song out with Share Location.
Not needed, I beg.
Not needed.
Nah, not needed.
Chinko Ekun, is it still a fine hit?
Yes, he's still looking for a hit. But I feel that if you're going to, I feel the collaboration would also help Chinko Ekun. You can't be collaborating all the time as an artist. But I feel that Chinko Ekun's brand is not strong enough at the moment to stand alone, to say, ah, it would take a whole lot for him to sing a song on his own at the moment, though.
But he, when he, but blows, he milked Evil God well, though.
Like, he milked it well
before he even decided to drop another single.
Yeah, he did actually. He did actually. What I think he should have done was actually to maybe get it Naira Marley or together on Lamide on a single, and boom.
Right, we're going to move on. There's a Yonder EP out there, and it's titled Wild Blue.
Wild Blue. Is Yonder signed to the DMW?
See, all these signings to DMW, I think they're more of
affiliations.
Affiliations, because I don't think Ayofe is DMW.
Yeah, it's OMW.
Obama.
Obama Music Worldwide.
Is that really a thing? I thought they scrapped that.
No, it was Aloma Music Worldwide.
Okay, Aloma. So there's Obama Music Worldwide.
Yeah, Obama.
No problem. Listen, I also get LMW.
Lala Music Worldwide.
What are we doing? I'm going to show you.
Savad. Okay, so Ayofe.
We're talking Yonder.
Oh, sorry, Yonder.
Wait, well, you can say both of them, because it's Ayofe and Mayor Kun.
So let's go to Yonder. You know, Yonder's EP, you know, Wild Blue. I mean, it's time to, like, it was about time, you know, that he dropped an EP and everything. And but I feel that there's a song on that EP featuring Davido. I think that's like the most disappointing, you know, song of that. That one, Agado. A couple of other songs actually projected the Yonder style of music. Agado was trash, to be honest. I loved a couple of other songs on the EP, but that one featuring Davido was not good enough at all. It is not a Yonder kind of song. Yeah, but yes, overall good EP. I expected you know, a lot more better from him, but of course I feel that 2021 is going to be a good year for Yonder if he's going to go on a consistent run of form.
We'll see if he does that, but I think Tony Tomato of that was
cut. Yeah, Tony Tomato. Nice. Amazing song. I love the song.
All right, we'll move on to Wajir, who has a new song.
Ayofe.
Oh, Ayofe, yeah, go on.
Ayofe tried. Yes, why is everybody trying to put me up on some Amapiano, you know, vibe?
Because it's, see.
Of Lagos?
Because, not really of. Is it mostly because of Lagos? Oh, yeah, because of Lagos. He's one of the Nigerian artists who have successfully. It's just one song
of Lagos.
If you see the amount of people who have tried Amapiano, like
if almost everyone has failed.
Meokun is the only one that seems to have done it really well. So if someone wants to join Amapiano song, why not just get Meokun if you have the chance?
Okay, so I think on this one, Ayofe style isn't Amapiano. So getting a Meokun to come and do Amapiano and everything and see what's going on. It was some lyrics were South African or maybe Kenyan or something. Some, you know, non-Nigerian lyrics on a song that's so basically meant for Nigeria. You are not an international artist yet. So people from SA are not going to say, oh, they want to listen to an Ayofe. Maybe Meokun could tilt them towards that. But I think for now, trying to go Amapiano and then non-Nigerian lyrics is a fail.
You know what I feel? I think this song is not for the Nigerian audience.
Okay.
I think he sang it because think about it. Amapiano is big way in South Africa. A lot of these guys who are doing Amapiano, right, are they looking at the Nigerian audience? I doubt it. They are looking at the guys who are big on Amapiano.
My point is no disrespect to Ayofe and his music and his craft, but you are not even blown in Lagos yet.
Okay, so you want to blow in South Africa?
Not talk of Nigeria. Then you want to blow in South Africa first and everything. I think that you should focus on music that will resonate around these people, before trying to say, David didn't start with, songs that would go to the UK or something, even Wizkid as well. Wizkid started with Pakurumo and everything. Things that people around to Lero Jolegba can resonate with before he tried to say, you know what, my sound is going to change because I'm going international. That's what Ayofe should do, not this, song he just did with Meokun, which is a total fail for me.
Alright, cool. But you guys can check that out.
Yeah, sure.
It'll be part of the playlist. There's also Wajir with Best Thing. Wajir has, I don't know, there was a time she was meant to have retired from the music thing, but now I think she's featured on a couple of tracks and now she has a song of her own.
Well, I think Wajir never disappoints. You know, that one is standard. You know, but the major issue. The song Best Thing is a good song, but I think one of the major issues with Wajir, same with Omaomi, is the consistency. Now we've heard Best Thing from Wajir, this is December 2020. Probably the next time we're going to hear from Wajir is December 2021.
Right.
No, that's the truth.
Because they never drop songs.
They don't drop songs and they are not always in the news.
But she said in that interview, if I remember well, that it takes a lot of resources money wise for her to push her music, which she doesn't have because she has to pay school fees for her daughter and things like that.
Bro, the truth is these guys are already big in terms of the brand. If YJ pushes out a song and say, you know what, I just want it to blow online only, you can do that. If it blows online, the radio guys will be forced to want to play it. TV guys will play if you get a director who will shoot for. I don't think it's about the money, the resources for YJ, because people have very limited resources and they still try to push. I know music business is not beans, you get, but I think that YJ with her brand can actually do more, you know. Well, that's the thing. I wanted to put her in the bracket of Kistaniel, but I think Kistaniel is still a bit fair.
So good luck to YJ on that Best Thing. You guys should check it out. So now I'm going to share his favorite. Okay, before we go to your favorite, let's talk Mr. P and Wandeko. Follow my lead.
I love Wandeko's part on that particular song. Yeah. Mr. P, no.
Why? What do you think Mr. P should do?
I think Mr. P. Ah, gosh. I was just about to say something.
No.
But follow my lead for me. I would listen to the song over and over again, but just Wandeko's part. Yeah, I wasn't impressed with Mr. P. Mr. P has not impressed me. Now, it could be any other person could be impressed, but for me, he has not impressed me as a standalone artist.
Really? Yeah. I mean, I could count a couple of songs with the guy.
The one with Yemi Alade didn't do well.
No, there's
the one with Nini Ola, actually. Yeah. You know, for me, it wasn't.
He didn't do well.
Yeah.
Hey!
That song, that's Tonight. I think Tonight is the one or something. For me, it wasn't a Mr. P. Like, for me, that is for me. I love Mr. P as a businessman. The Zoom Up Your Life thing is really, really doing well. But music, nah.
It's okay. It's okay. Off your mic. We're going to move on to Guilty Beats. He has a new song with Oxlade, Kiddy, and DJ Virosity.
Okay, I think I listened to that once. Mm-hmm. Yeah, Guilty Beats is a Ghanaian producer.
Yeah.
Oxlade did his thing on that song. Yeah, yeah. Did his thing on the, you know.
Oxlade, that's it, the hot hot right now, Abi. And he has a video for his song.
Is part of Oxygen. Yeah, Oxygen. Yes, yeah. That song is really good as well.
Yeah. Yeah.
Oxlade is actually he is it on the Next Rated Awards thing? He is.
It is on. Last year he was
Next Rated.
He's on Next Rated.
Was rookie last year.
Actually, Next Rated. No, he's not on Next Rated.
He is on Next Rated. Actually,
we had Thames.
Yeah, Oxlade is there. Belash Mother. Oxlade is there.
Oxlade is there.
Oxlade is there.
Okay. Good luck.
Yeah, good luck to him.
Good luck to all of them. With the last song we're going to spotlight that I want to share his thoughts on is Naramali's double release.
Hmm.
He has a new song out called Chi Chi.
Was it the one you're calling my favorite?
Yeah, it's your favorite now.
Naramali.
No, are you not a Malian?
Me.
I can go back a few videos.
My wife. No,
they wear belt, say you be Malian.
No, I never said that. You the capo.
At the camp.
Yeah,
the camp. I'll show you evidence.
I never said that. No, I love Naramali the same way I love Zlatan.
If you love Naramali, you're Davido. Malian.
No, I'm not a Malian. I love Naramali. I love Davido. I'm a 30 BG fan. I love Whiskey. I'm not saying I'm a star, but no.
You can be everything. You can be FC, you can be 30
BG. I'm everything and I'm nothing. For everybody. I'm for nobody. Let's go to Naramali's.
Naramali, Chi Chi, and Kole Yewon. What are your thoughts?
Chi Chi, Kole Yewon. Okay, let's move to Kole Yewon first.
Yeah.
Kole Yewon, when I listened to that song, I mean, I played the song and I was like, okay. It ended, and I did not get what Naramali was trying to do on that song.
Mm.
Now, for Chi Chi,
mm-hmm.
It's a jam. Love song. Yeah, Naramali is not a love guy. No, I don't have a Chi Chi.
Are you sure you don't have a Chi Chi?
I don't have a Chi Chi. Naramali tried to, you know, do the lover boy thing on Chi Chi, and I think, he did well.
All right. So, guys, you can check out this song. Some of the other songs that have been out today that you can check as well. There's Psycho YP, who has a new song out, National Anthem. There's a new album by DJ Spino, Grace album.
Grace,
you guys should check that out. I think that's about it.
Funke Akindele, Fuma Akota, Elena Badmus and Bim Bottomus released the Askamaya anthem as well.
I don't understand. But the video looks fun to watch.
Yeah.
And I think those guys, they're established.
Dutchman as well. Dropped the song. Dutchman dropped the song.
That's know, number what?
Number eight what? For the year. Orezi as well. Started Ronaldo. Giveaway. Orezi as well. Ronaldo, Nasty Girl. You know, he dropped a new single, Orezi. And I think there's just been a whole lot of music this year alone.
Yeah, don't you pay me, I beg.
Do you understand?
Yeah.
It's been so much. Anyway, shout out to every Nigerian artist doing really, really well for the craft. We love you and we appreciate your craft. But for us here on New Music Fridays, we try to say it the way it is, according to our opinion.
According to your opinion.
According to my opinion. According to my opinion.
Okay.
According to my opinion.
So that's what Sheyi has had to say.
Yes.
As you guys know, I'm always happy to be on this side of the
music of the week.
Your music of the week, yes.
Yes.
Oh, yeah, change your music of the week.
Okay, so I'm going to go with for the music of the week for this week.
You want me to give you an option?
Nah, don't give me an option. Please.
No, like listen.
Nah. I mean, a couple of these songs here, not impressive for me. So I'm going to go with the one that I'm actually very impressed with. My guys, The Cavemen, with
Very predictable.
Yes.
Very predictable.
Let me be like that. Cavemen, my song of the week. Guys, go listen to that one.
All right, guys, that's all we have time for today. I'm going to update the playlist as usual and leave the link in the description. If you want something for Christmas, please ask Sheyi. Sheyi, when they sang Monino de Lagos, Sheyi then they talk about.
You have a giveaway for them, though.
Yes, we do have a giveaway actually. If any of you guys who use Boomplay, we have some Boomplay coins available. There's about 10 of them, so that's like 10,000 naira worth of Boomplay coins.
Mm-hmm.
So if you'd like to be one of the winners, check the description for what you have to do.
Yeah.
And then also check Gusto Entertainment IG on our Instagram page.
Yeah.
We're going to put the instructions on there on how you can win ₦1,000 each in Boomplay coins. You can easily to subscribe for your Boomplay subscription. We're pro. We don't download music illegally over here. We are pro digital stores. So yeah, thank you guys. We'll see you on the next episode of Gusto Music Friday.
Thank you, guys. Thank you.
Adios.
Thank you, guys.
Adios, amigos.
Adios, amigos. Peace.